Hi guys. After the THU in which I went to the talk by Alessandro Baldassarroni, and he talked about how important edge maps were for creating the roughness at the edges of geometry to make them look like as if they were worn and old. I tried to think of a way of getting those same edge maps within the software I already use in my pipeline. So I wanted to try to get edge maps in ZBrush, and when I tried, I had some problems, but eventually I managed to go over them, and now I've got a sort of very fast solution to create edge maps in ZBrush. It's a very little tip or trick, but let me show you how I do it. So let's start with this. With the Captain Bunny helmet I have, and this is an already retopologized asset. You can see that the geometry is really clean. It will be already prepared. Also, it already has UV maps. So, and I would want to create an edge map for this. So I would crank this up to its maximum subdivisions, and if I try to create a cavity map here, which would be the way to create an edge map, I will have some problems. So if I mask by cavity, you'll see that all the stains I get here do not correspond to the edges that I want them to follow. I want in fact that the rust or the dirt would go along all these edges, which would be the more exposed edges of the geometry, but the fact is that that's not happening at all. So how did I manage to work around this? The first thing you have to do is to make a copy of your original object. So you'll just come here at the subtools, hit duplicate. Like we put this in solo mode, so now we're only seeing the duplicate. Now what we have to do is to convert this into a DynaMesh. I'll crank the resolution of the DynaMesh up here and convert this to DynaMesh. It is already converted to DynaMesh. You can see that it's looking really, really dense now. This is very important because what happened is that the cavity map was not working because ZBrush will make the gradients based on the distance between vertexes. And the DynaMesh has got this property of having most vertexes distributed uniformly over the surface. So now if we go to masking, and we do the cavity masking, you'll see that the distribution is a lot more along what we want. Even though it is the invert of what we want, it's masking the interior parts instead of the exterior parts. So let's go to the mask by cavity menu and basically go to the focal shift and reverse it. It's about minus 90 by default. Let's put it at something like 90. And if you do mask by cavity, you already have something very close to what you might want. So you have the edges unmasked in this case. By lowering the intensity, you can make those edges sharper. So this is a lot more like what you would expect from an edge map. Now, let me clear the mask. And let's fill this with a color, with a white color just before masking, so that now we can fill the edges with black. Let's go to color again and fill the unmasked areas. So, we have our edge map not the edge map painted on the surface, but the fact is that we are on the dynamesh surface and not on the good topology. So let's go back to our good topology mesh, which has the UVs but doesn't have the edge map. And let's start by doing one thing. Let's go to the morph target and store the form as a morph target. Then let's go back to the painted dynamesh, and let's do the following. Let's go to the original object and project all. When we say to project all, he's going to project not only the form, but he's also going to project the color, and that's what we want. Sometimes he will ask you if you want to project the color too. You say yes, because that's exactly what we want. But when we do the projection, as he projects the form too, he might be changing a little bit the geometry. That's why we have made the morph target. So you get back to the morph target, you can just hit switch so that you recover your geometry. So now what we have the good topology with a polypaint of the edge map. So now all you have to do is go to the texture map and then create and hit new from polypaint, and you'll get a map with the edge map. So all you have to do now is just clone texture, go to the texture menu and just export your edge map. So basically what you have is the here's what your edge mask would look like. It's really easy. All you have to take care is about creating a dynamesh so that the distance between the vertexes is uniform, so that it will catch well all the cavities, and then project that detail, especially the color, back to the original mesh, and with the morph target you'll restore the original form. And that's how you do it. I hope you like this tip. See you next time.